Hello and welcome to The Simple Game Dev. In this special episode called Speed Modeling Ninja Mouse Part 1, we are going to see the process of creating a very simple low poly character for a game. Now, since it's a speed modeling, I'm really going to talk about just the overall, method that I use normally when creating a 3D character. In this case, the 3D character we're going to be making, the Ninja Mouse, is for a mobile game. Thus, is going to be a low poly character. It's going to be very simple. It won't require too many polygons, and obviously all the detail is going to be handled in the texture state. So right now I'm trying to focus more on the shape, and what I'm doing right now is starting with a basic circle that I'm extruding, and I'm cutting it in half. Then I'm just adding some loop cuts to try to get that overall shape of the body. Now I'm moving some vertices and deleting some faces so that I can extrude the limbs. In this case, I'm starting with the legs. And as mentioned before, since it's a mobile game and it's going to be very tiny on screen, I'll try to keep it as low poly as possible. And I'm just adding loop cuts where I know there's going to be bending or deformations. In this case, I added some loop cuts on the knee so that I can avoid stretching in the texture. That's usually what I do. I keep everything very low poly, at least for this type of games, and then I will focus on the details during the texture state. Now, once again, I'm adding extra loop cuts where I know the character is going to have some deformations. In this case, the elbow is going to bend, obviously, so I add an extra loop cut. Now, what I'm doing here is just extruding a little plane that is going to be the tail. One of the things that you normally do when modeling characters is modeling just half of the character and then mirror the rest. In Blender, there's a modifier called mirror, a mirror modifier, which is one I use all the time to save on time. Most of the time your characters are going to be symmetrical, so that's just going to be basically your best friend during modeling. Now what I'm doing here with the head is basically grabbing a cube and using a modifier to subdivide it and start giving the overall shape of the head. Now again, I'm not too worried about the details or specific geometry of the character, because I just want to get the overall shape of the character. As you can see, I'm keeping every part separate. And in the last state, I'm just going to merge everything. I'm trying to keep everything very simple, using just basic shapes and just adding loop cuts where I need them, but always try to keep a very low poly mesh. I just created a sphere that will be the eye. And now I'm adding some details on the face to create the cheek and more details for the forehead and overall shape of the face. Now again, since this character is not going to be it's not going to have a facial animation or any type of special close-up render, I'm trying to keep it very, very simple and low poly. Now normally I would be worried about topology, but in this case I'm just trying to get the shape, since the game and the design document is a top-down game. You are most likely never gonna see the character up top, from the front angle. Right now I'm just adding the last details of the belt and just modifying some vertices and trying to get the shape that I want. Now it's that's pretty much it for this video. In the next one we are going to see how to unwrap this model. Don't forget to check out my other videos if you're interested in game development or 3D modeling. Please subscribe to stay up to date with new uploads and help support this channel. If you have any questions, feedback, or requests, please drop me a line on the comments section. I'd love to hear what your thoughts are. My name is Remy Storms, and I'll see you on the next video. Thanks a lot for watching.